Hey everyone, I'm Gurleen. I hope you're doing well. In today's video, we'll be discussing the trade plan for tomorrow, that is April 21st, 2023 for Nifty and Bank Nifty. We'll also discuss a few select stocks wherein good risk to reward opportunities are brewing up. So be sure to stick around till the end of the video and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button and do ring the notification bell so that you never miss an update. Now, right before we start, do let me know how was the expiry day for you in the comments down below. So without any further ado, let's take a look at the technical perspective, starting with Nifty 50 on the daily time frame. Now, as we've been discussing over the last 3 days, once again Nifty traded sideways within this range of the candlestick that was registered in Monday's trading session, and it is also holding very well above the 200 simple moving average. Now, in today's trading session, the put writers defended the lower end of the range very strongly, and here you can see that Nifty respected the range perfectly on the expiry day. Now, there's not much change in the stance, and either the index can continue to trade sideways or consolidate here, or if we do see a breakdown at this level of 17,574, then a decline towards the levels of 17,500 to 17,485 can be anticipated, and it might as well turn out to be a deeper retracement. Now, these are the early signs that we'll be watching out for in case of Nifty. Now, because the sideways grind is going on, it might be very difficult for directional traders to capitalize on these choppy and erratic moves within the range. So one can sit out and wait patiently for the setup to develop and unfold. So the bottom line here is that it's very likely for the index to continue to trade or spend some time sideways over here within this range until and unless we see a decisive breakout, and this level of 17,574 can be considered as the immediate strong support for the index. Also, you might ask that what about the upside? So the potential upside over here would only open up above this range of 17,770 for the targets of about 17,840 to 17,926. Now let's take a look at the hourly time frame. Here you can see that Nifty started to cool off from the wide harmonic potential reversal zone, and you can see that how Nifty traded within such a narrow range right above the support level of 17,574. Now, you can also see a continuous decline and even a breakdown below the hourly moving averages, and only this level of 17,574 is holding Nifty together. So if you are looking for a fresh short trade, the possibility would only open up below the breakdown of this level of 17,574, and in that case Nifty can possibly test the downside levels of about 17,500 to 17,485 to begin with. And if this setup gets triggered, so in that case I will be considering an invalidation level of 17,710. Now let's talk about the support and resistance levels for Nifty. So the support is placed at 17,500 followed by 17,395, whereas the resistance is placed at 17,770 followed by 17,840. Now let's move to Bank Nifty. So it was a calm expiry in Bank Nifty as the index traded within a narrow range of 250 to 280 points, and as we had been discussing, it expired within this wide range of 41,800 to 42,600. Now, if you've been a regular watcher of the videos, we have been discussing since Monday that considering such a wide range candlestick on the daily charts, it is a no trade zone, and market might continue to remain within this range until and unless it gets some kind of a clue, be it geopolitical or some US related data, etc. Also, Bank Nifty was largely subdued in the absence of any stock specific moves. So the weekly expiry has gone by and Bank Nifty is still trading within this range of 41,800 to 42,600. Now here the positive momentum would only open up above this level of 42,600, which can also be considered as a resistance level in the near term, and it's also crucial for Bank Nifty to hold above the level of 41,800. Now let's take a look at the hourly chart. So unlike Nifty, Bank Nifty is placed above the hourly moving averages, and here you can see another inside bar setup on the hourly chart. So this can turn out to be a nice intraday opportunity to capitalize upon. So if Bank Nifty opens flat within this range, so for a long trade, if we do see a breakout at this high of 42,378, then an immediate target of about 42,500 can be considered, and over here the invalidation level can be taken as the level of 42,075. For a short trade, a breakdown at this low of 42,111 would bring in an immediate target of about 41,991, followed by 41,800 on the downside. So that's how you can capitalize on opportunities within this wide range, and a major shift in the trend will only be at the breakout or the breakdown of this range on the daily charts. Now let's talk about the support and resistance levels for Bank Nifty. So the support is placed at 41,800, followed by 41,540, whereas the resistance is placed at 42,505, followed by 42,605. Now let's move to stocks. Let's start with Grasim on the hourly charts. So you can see that Grasim has broken below this pivot of 1691.30, and this has triggered a harmonic pattern on the hourly chart, and a fresh short trade might play out below this level of 1680. Now in that case, an estimated target of about 1628 can be considered over here with an invalidation level of 1735. So the risk can be adjusted accordingly. Now moving forward with the next one, that is Cipla. Now here you can see that Cipla is placed above this polarity zone of 896 to 899, and we also have an inside bar setup on the charts. So it's a conditional setup, which simply means that a shorting opportunity over here would only open up below this level of 899, and in that case an immediate target of about 886 can be looked at in Cipla with an invalidation level of 914. And what if we see a breakout first? So if we do see a breakout at this level of 914, then a potential long opportunity can be looked at, wherein these lows placed at the levels of 899 to 896 can be considered as the invalidation level. So as of now, Cipla is a wait and watch candidate, and one can strike as and when the setup unfolds. Also, there have been a lot of queries around Shri Cement, so let's take an overview. Now here on the daily charts, you can see a decline going on for the last 5 trading sessions, and Shri Cement has broken below this support level of 24,750. Now in this case, it's likely for the decline to extend towards the levels of 23,672, followed by 23,240, and the possibility of a pullback as well cannot be ruled out. So all in all, it's a highly risky bet, so one should avoid trading it. And on that note, it's Gurleen signing off. Until we meet again, have a good time.